Hurricane Beryl made landfall this morning across the Texas coast as a Category 1 hurricane. Since then, it has downsized, downgraded now to a tropical storm. You can see it here, expected to move towards Arkansas. As it does so, it'll actually drop down into a tropical depression. But tonight is going to be a severe night for both River Valley and Northwest Arkansas because we're going to be monitoring for the potential of a lot of rain in a relatively short amount of time that could bring some concerns when it comes to flooding. You can see here's 10 o'clock this morning. Temperatures mainly into the 80s. We're watching for a few scattered showers. It's not until this afternoon and especially this evening that we'll start to feel the impacts from Beryl. It is going to come down as that heavy rain with River Valley experiencing most of it. A lot of our models are picking up on about 1 to 3 inches of total rain. Some areas receiving about 4 to 6. But if you live in a flood prone area, a low lying area, really make sure you are ready for this. This continues not only tonight, but into the overnight hours. This is 2 a.m. for your Tuesday morning. This is when it could be the heaviest. So again, flooding is our main concern for everyone. It continues through the drive commute, the early commute tomorrow. And then as we progress through Tuesday afternoon, the storm is out of Arkansas, but definitely going to be concerning. By Tuesday afternoon, back to sunny skies and warm, very mild weather taking us into the end of our work week and into the weekend. But I do want to talk about the threat of a few possible stronger storms. The threat is the greatest to the south of us. We can see it here, but some of us could actually see a few of those stronger storms develop as Beryl moves through Arkansas overnight and into Tuesday morning. As that happens, we need to be watching for strong damaging winds. The tornado threat, it's low, but it's not zero. So your 4029 weather team will be on it, really monitoring for you. Again, our major concern is going to be flooding. The National Weather Service does have most of our viewing area under a flood watch that starts today. It'll be in place until Tuesday afternoon.